Coming to you from the middle of the world, the one and only, from Telesur Studios in Quito, Ecuador. It's our privilege and our pleasure to introduce you to Andrew Zell.
If you spent any time on a social network site, or just actually been alive in the last 10 years, you've probably come across a troll. Now, if you're lucky, you've just seen them commenting on your favorite YouTube video with profanities, or if you're unlucky, they're pointing out that you look kind of ugly in that Facebook photo that you shouldn't have uploaded yourself. But anyway, the troll's raison d'etre is to make people feel bad and uncomfortable, but they're easily swatted away with the block button or a delete or something like this. But the reason I'm talking about trolls is because there's been a bit of an outrage lately, because there's been state-sponsored trolls. Ever since Russia and Ukraine got into a bit of a dilly-dally over there on the border, Russia has been paying for trolls to write nice things about Russia on the internet, bad things about Ukraine on the internet. But the real thing is, Russia doesn't need trolls. Putin already rules the internet. And just like this Russian friend of his, he'll be trolling all the way. Welcome to The Self Show. Putin rules the internet. Putin is a movie-style action hero. He's fit. He's manly. And he's so fit and manly, he always has people writing on pieces of paper behind the scenes to make sure he keeps winning and stays fit and manly. His propaganda comes up against the legalized unicorn bestiality program, and his to-do list looks like it's come out of Lex Luthor's playbook. Now, to prove this, the Kremlin has released a wonderful video of him and his Prime Minister Medvedev working out in a sun-dappled gym in Sochi. Now they're walking around silently, working out on those kinds of machines that your CrossFit friends are constantly making fun of. See, this decision to release the kind of footage of Putin in unflattering sweatpants doing calf raises, well, just might seem odd to the casual observer. But of course, this is part of the Putin propaganda campaign. I mean, the man subdues tigers, he talks with dolphins, he rides in tiny submarines, he flies tiny planes, children and dogs love him. I mean, this is the Putin we all hear and love. But what is this all about? Is it that if Putin is good, Russia is good? So he needs to show that everything is going well. But what means if we don't get Putin propaganda? Is Russia not doing so well?
Vladimir Putin's latest tough guy stunt included reeling in a giant pike and, after an assistant asked whether the fish can bite, replying, "I myself can bite it." Instead, he proceeded to kiss it. It was the latest adventure for the Russian president, considered by supporters as a strong leader and by critics as a little tyrant.
You see, if Putin's power starts to slip, will he start swimming with dolphins again and riding more horses, nude, bareback, whatever the hell he does? But this sort of propaganda might be a sign of bad things to come. When you see Putin and Medvedev broing out the gym, it might actually mean that his grip on power is starting to worsen. And then there is this self-show revealing special. See, the Mona Lisa, painted in the 1500s, is one of the world's all-time famous paintings. 9.3 million people visit the Louvre just to get 15 seconds, get a selfie in front of it when there's much better paintings behind it, just to see this. But unlike best-selling authors, historians, there is a deeper truth to be found in the Mona Lisa. A shocking truth can be revealed if you look at it from the right angle. You see, Vladimir Putin either is the wife of a Franciscan noble, or he went back in time and posed as Da Vinci. One of these is probably true. Probably. But wait, the mystery deepens even further. Putin may be the foundation of modern art as we know it. Look at this one. He is a 16th century Greek general. He was also in the 18th century painting by Jan van Eyck. Also in an M.C. Escher painting. You see, Putin is a 16th century general. He's an 18th century Dutch model. He's a 19th century abstract kind of dude. He's everyone. And don't worry, we're investigating this. So you may have seen these mapping prejudice maps. You know, sort of Asia for Americans and the rest of the world according to Germans. And that actually is a pretty useful one. Europe according to Vladimir Putin. Of course, it doesn't quite get everything wrong, because the whole of Europe should be union of incestual homosexuals who are trying to overthrow Great Russia. And earlier this year, Kyrgyzstan named a mountain after Vladimir Putin. Now, for those without rudimentary geographic knowledge or the willingness to search the internet, Kyrgyzstan doesn't even border Russia. It's not even really that close to Russia. But I guess when you're sharing the same continent with a man like Putin, you gotta do something to suck up to him. The communications minister of Kyrgyzstan even said that he thought the mountain wasn't big enough at 13,000 feet. Now, Vladimir Putin, being the man he is, didn't say, "This is too great an honor for me to take on, send a beautiful letter to the people of Kyrgyzstan." Instead, he said, with a man of manliness that he really is, he wants to climb it. Only a man like Putin would want to conquer everything that has his name on it. But you see, the really remarkable thing is everyone in the West swallows this tough guy persona. This is the Russia that they want to project, and the Russia that the West is swallowing. And to look at it in kind of a different way, you look at some of his draconian homophobic policies. There might be something in this. Putin hanging out with tigers, flaming homosexual. Him riding horses shirtless. Total village people bullshit. But aside from the dubious essentialization of sexual difference and maybe some homophobic remarks, that previous thing I said actually misses the point completely. You see, Putin is a nerd. So he had this career in intelligence, but intelligence is not all umbrellas with poison darts and putting stuff on James Bond's dick. What it really is sitting around doing nothing. You see, Putin spent most of his time in Dresden. All he did was write reports while all his Stasi mates did the decent legwork. And he has all the common dreams of a nerd. Judo, fighter planes, all that weird gay shit he does, along with invading sovereign countries. The guy's a dork. And Western condemnation of Vladimir Putin has taken a lackluster form. Now, this is probably helped by the fact who's leading this up is this guy John Kerry, who's an absolute dullard with a face that kind of looks like a pencil eraser, like long and oblong like that, and a guy who comes from a New England boarding school, boring as batshit, who managed to lose an election to George W. Bush but still finds himself in power through a combination of dim-witted persistence and $750 million in the bank. Now you see, Vladimir Putin is an expert ironist. He's like the God of the Old Testament, Maximilian Robespierre, General Butt Naked, and the Google I'm Feeling Lucky button, an expert ironist. You see, Putin isn't really even close to what you think he is, or what even he thinks he is. Whatever the West says about him, then he multiplies by what he says, and then stupid shows like this one make the situation even worse. You see, probably the best way to destroy Putin and Russia would be just to ignore them.
Putin is also seen at the helm of a speeding motorboat and later feeding a reindeer during the excursion in Siberia. He took the trip with Prime Minister Dmitry Medvedev and Defense Minister Sergei Shoigu. In the past, Putin has tranquilized and collared a Siberian tiger and polar bear. He has released two rare West Asian leopards into a sanctuary and shot darts at whales. He has flown a motorized hang glider to help lead a flock of cranes. He has piloted a fighter jet. Accusations abound that some of his antics are staged, a throwback to the days when Soviet propaganda glorified its leaders. For instance, critics say the so-called wild Siberian tiger really came from the zoo. Putin was also forced to admit that, during a Black Sea dive, he didn't really discover two ancient Greek urns. They were planted there for him.